Color is one of the most essential components of the visual world, and it is good to start experimenting with different ways of selecting them as much as possible. In this lesson, I will show you various ways to select colors and how to make color palettes. Tap on the colored circle here on the top right corner. This circle shows the currently selected color that you're going to draw or paint with. Then you have these two little squares used in certain brushes to create special effects. The first icon on the bottom menu is the disc, and this mode is the one that comes by default. You can select the base color with the outer hue ring and adjust how light, dark, or saturated you want it to be by using the inner circle. To have a wider range of color choices, you can zoom in on this middle circle by spreading two fingers over it and pinching on it to close it and select another color. When you're in the disc mode, you can double tap on different areas of the circle to select pure colors. This way, you'll be able to achieve a pure white, a pure black color, and brighter hues. Let's tap on the second icon, which says Classic. The Classic mode has a more traditional approach to color. You will find that programs like Photoshop share this way of displaying colors. At the bottom, you have three sliders. The first one adjusts the hue. Here you can choose the base color that you want to work with. The second bar is for choosing the saturation, which defines the brightness of a color. And in the third bar, you can define how light or dark you want your color to be. For any color that you choose, you will also be able to define the saturation and lightness within the top square. Play around with these ways of choosing colors as you work on your illustrations and see what you like the most. These other two modes are a bit more advanced, and I never use them, so I will leave them aside. Another way of choosing colors is using the color picker. It allows you to select colors that are already on a photo or artwork. I will open one of my illustrations to show you how this works. If I tap and hold my finger on the screen, the eyedropper tool appears. This tool lets you select a color already displayed on the canvas. It appears as a ring surrounding my circle. In the bottom half, I can see the primary color that I'm already using, and on the top, I can choose the color that I want to replace it with. Then if I lift my finger, the primary color will change. Before moving on, there is something I want to share. This tutorial is part of my online class, Digital Illustration, a beginner's guide to mastering Procreate. In this class, I will teach you how to use Procreate from the very beginning, and we will explore each tool in depth. While creating a simple set of botanical assets, you will get to practice the drawing and painting tools. I will teach you different ways to select colors, how to organize your layers, tricks to modify your brushes so that you can draw easily, how to use the symmetry tool to create stunning flowers, and towards the end of the class, I will show you how to use advanced transforming tools to create an infinite number of stunning plants. If you want to take this class, you can use the code listed on the description of this video. Use it and you'll be able to access thousands of Skillshare classes for free for 30 days. Okay, back to the tutorial. As you can see, when I tap on the color circle, the colors that I have been using appear under the history row of swatches. In here, you will see all the colors that you've been working on recently. But after 10 colors used, they will start disappearing. If you tap on the palette icon, you will see some palettes which come by default. As you can see, I've created a few, and I like to try them across different projects, or I use them also to test colors in a very quick way. To create a new palette, tap on this plus icon in here, and then select Create New Palette from the drop-down menu. And you will see an empty set of squares at the top of the panel. You can rename it by tapping on the untitled word. And if you go back to the disc or the classic mode, you will see that this new empty palette appears in here. I'll start choosing a couple of colors so that I can show you how this works. So I will choose a nice orange bright color, and once I'm happy with it, I will add it to the palette by tapping on the first square. I will now choose a lighter orange and tap on the second square to add it to the palette. I will also add a darker orange, and then I will tap on the third square once I'm happy with it. You can also switch to the classic mode to choose some greens and experiment with the second way of picking colors. This way you can see which one do you prefer. You can organize these colors by touching and dragging their swatches to another place in the palette. And if you touch, hold, and lift your finger, you can delete any color. Don't worry, as these colors are not the definite ones that you have to work with. And at any point, you can start adding new colors to the palette, deleting them or reorganizing them. All of your palettes will be saved under the palettes icon, and you can reorganize them the same way as you organized your colors. You just have to touch and hold the palette down and then drag it to wherever you want it to be. If you tap on these three dots, you can share, duplicate, or delete the palettes. I can also select set as default so that when I go back to the disk mode, it appears in here.
If you like this tutorial, don't forget to subscribe to So Creative's channel. This tutorial is part of my online class, Digital Illustration, a beginner's guide to mastering Procreate. In this class, I will teach you how to create stunning plants out of a single set of botanical assets. And in the process, you will learn, practice, and master all the necessary tools to create beautiful digital illustrations.